and I wanted to wish you a happy Mother's Day. I am so happy to celebrate with you in the joys of motherhood, and that is also extended to anybody who has fur babies or who are caregivers or who want to be a mother and is not yet a mother. You also get a happy Mother's Day from the bottom of my heart. It takes a special kind of person to have that kind of maternal love for other people, for creatures, for anything with a soul that is remotely sentient. It is a fantastic, selfless thing that you do by taking care of others and loving and I have no good way to put it. I practiced this 3 times and I've got nothing to say because I have nothing but respect. I can't articulate it to the fullest extent of how much I want to share that kind of love and appreciation for you. So thank you. Happy Mother's Day. So this is more of a vlog as much as it is a haul. My mother is advanced stages of Huntington's disease. She is only 61 years old, and I struggled with gifts for her, and I've made her things. I've crocheted, I've baked, you know, I've gotten pictures of the family for her, and it's a struggle. So I'm making this video so that maybe it might help somebody else pick gifts for somebody who isn't necessarily the same person that they were. Huntington's disease is a mentally and physically regressive disease. It is hereditary. I got tested, I don't have it, and I have no chance of passing it on to my children. There is a particular chromosome in your DNA that repeats, and if you have so many of these repeats, then you have Huntington's disease, and you are going to get it. You just don't know when the onset of symptoms are. It's 40 repeats and above. Mine were 19. They were well below passing it on. So nobody that I have birthed is going to have it or is able to pass it down unless somehow magically they are linked up with somebody who has that mutation. And even then, it's a 50-50 flip of a coin, and it is scary and terrifying and emotional. My mother has her master's degree from the Duquesne University. She is a reading specialist and a teacher certified from K through 12. It was a struggle. My mother would read books this thick in days, and she was sharp as a tack and very loving and very goofy and always clumsy, but so am I. And to watch her not be able to write her own name or read a card is just, I don't know. My mom was the epitome of fashion. She did makeup. She wore some of the most beautiful jewelry I've ever seen in my life. Exquisite, conservative taste. She's not as alternative of me. If you could, she was a child of the 50s. Like, she was born in 54? No. 56? 57? I can math. I'm bad. But she was born in the late 50s, and so she had that 50s kind of model household into the 60s, 70s. She was teaching during the 80s boom and the economic kind of growth, and my dad was making buku bucks at the time, and I mean, my grandpa owned a bakery, and he worked his fingers to the bone, so she had brand new cars, and he paid for her education in cash, like no student loans. She did it all. Amazing. And now she drools and she struggles to remember my name, and it's really hard. I broke down in the middle of Target when I was shopping for her, and I just lost it. I just cried because I miss my mom. And everybody's like, she's still with you. She's still with you. And she does have these moments of clarity where she comes through. But even then, when she answers, she's slurring and it's just not like her. It's hard. She doesn't dress like how she used to dress. It's just not the same. I can't talk to her. I can't have home conversations, and I miss my mom. So I struggled. I got set off because of a t-shirt, actually. There was this beautiful boat neck top at Target that had these stripes, and it had these sequin palm trees on it, and my mom loved Quacker Factory from QVC, and I guess she still does. There's things that, like I said, they still come through, but it was quite glamorous. I could have seen her teaching in the top or going out for brunch in it, and I put it back because she kind of lives in t-shirts and sweatshirts and stuff now, and sweatpants. But I did find some clothes for her. So I started out with this gorgeous kind of tangerine classic kind of sweater here. It's the old standard, this nice sweater. And the camera's not picking up the color, but it's more of like a salmon tangerine than orange in the picture, in the camera. But she gets cold. The Huntington's disease, you are always cold. It could be 100 degrees outside and you are still cold. But I got some stuff to layer with it, so I hope it's not, it's a t-shirt material top, but it's got these little spring ladybugs on it, and I could just see her rocking it. And then I got to go with it these kind of summer drinks. My mom liked fruity chick drinks, I guess. She can't drink anymore, but I know she's gonna recognize these. And there's just the tiniest little sequin as the garnish on these, which I think is just adorable. And it's this beautiful pink. My mom wore very conservative color palette. Actually, I'm gonna be a jerk. Do that. Okay, so she wore a very conservative color palette, bright colors, but she was very sophisticated. She wouldn't be walking around in day glow green. And she still has her hair very much the same as she always kept it. My stepdad, amazing human being, gets it done for her every month, every couple months, when the roots need touched up and the ends need trimmed. And she used to pull back in headbands, but she hated the way that the plastic headbands would hurt her ears. So I got her some fabric headbands and in bright spring colors and classic black. And I'm hoping that my stepdad remembers that she likes these if I give them to her, just to get the hair out of her face, especially when he's feeding her, the hair gets like in her mouth. And her lips are always dry. I think she has a hard time drinking liquids because of the hard time swallowing, and that stuff that makes the liquid pudding-like, so she doesn't choke. She doesn't like it, so he tries not to put that in there if he doesn't have to. So I got this, like, again, sticking with the spring summer, I got the Burt's Bees pink grapefruit lip balm for her with the sunflower oil and the beeswax coconut oil. I love Burt's Bees. I swear by them. But she doesn't do makeup anymore. I mean, she can't even put it on. We have to do it for her. I got her these Pacifica Pineapple Wipeout Oil Cleansers to wash your face. Ricky buys her a lot of different wipes to get the stuff off of her face, the food and the drool and stuff. But I thought, get her something gorgeous and pretty, and I know she's gonna light up when she sees this because she'll recognize these things. But this is 100% vegan and cruelty free, so I thought we'd give it a try with pineapple extract. So we'll see.
And then he has a hard time bathing her, so I don't know if my stepdad knows what this is, but I'll teach him. I got her the Beach Babe texturizing dry shampoo. So, in fact, I just ran some through my hair because I got off work and, but mine's a different brand. This is, I buy my mom nicer stuff than what I have, but it's the Beach Babes. I know it says not your mother's, but it's going to be my mother's with the coconut, toasted coconut smell. My mom loves coconut. And then she also really loves vanilla, and I found this detangling leave-in conditioner, because she still gets it lightened. Her hair is still bleached blonde, so there's this leave-in conditioner for Doll, because Ricky has to comb her hair, so he has a bunch of different detanglers, but I found this in the travel section at Target, so it's more of a little sample size, and I thought that would be... Oh, I dropped stuff. That's okay. I'll get it later. And then I only got a few more things. And then for her room, just to bring the beach to her, I got this Ocean Breeze Room Refresher from the J.R. Watkins line of products from Target. I love the vintage feel of the packaging, and this just smells awesome. So my beachy bum mum gets a little bit more beach, which is great. And then last but not least, I got her kind of this adult sippy cup, and I still use these, but it has these really cute little watermelons on it. Logan loves watermelon. My mom likes watermelon a lot. Now, she can't really suck too well, but she can drink from cans and stuff, so I thought that this would be nice. So it's a double wall insulated to keep her drinks cool in the summer. I use adult sippy cups, so I don't feel shameful buying them for somebody that is mentally regressing, because I use them. I don't feel that this is an insult. So, and last but not least, just to keep the fabrics in the bag nice and to keep with my beach theme, I got the sachet for her drawer and for the bag for it. It's the coral reef. I got this at Pakatan. It's the only thing I didn't get at Target. But, you know, it was just some things, you know. So I don't know if you have a more elderly mom or a sick mom like I have, but I thought these would be nice little things. I'm not my mom's caretaker. I go up to visit my mommy a lot, but because of the custody agreement I have with Logan's father, I can't leave the county that I'm in, and she is literally like 3 minutes over the line for the other county, so it kind of sucks. So I visit a lot, so I can't wait to wrap this stuff up and give it to her for tomorrow. But I feel like if you also had somebody who was recently injured and had a hard time bathing or needed taken care of or in the hospital, that these kind of things would be nice. If I didn't think of something for somebody who has Huntington's disease or is handicapped in a way that daily life, basic grooming or something is impossible, let me know. I mean, I made her slippers. She can still kind of walk, but she does this like pause, and then her coordination is horrendous. She has cracked the two front teeth out of her face because she's fallen, black eyes because she's falling, and there's nothing that you can do. You'd be standing 2 feet from her, she just shuffles away from you and falls forward, and then it's game over. And you were standing right there. It was like when I was watching Logan when he was two, toddling around, and then poof, right off of something. And of course with the kid it's adorable, and then when it's your parent it's kind of just sad. It's very sad. So I'm rambling. This is very cathartic for me. Just to have a discussion about it. I saw some people on YouTube that had the Huntington's awareness and that they were trying to do a pie on a face for the same thing as the ice bucket challenge that they had for ALS a couple years ago. But it's sad, and it's just kind of funny. My mom's the first one in the family that ever showed symptoms enough to get diagnosed, and it's going to die with her because me and my twin brother
don't have it. I'm gonna post a link down below for the Huntington's kind of like awareness website, and then if you could if I forgot something that would be a nice gift because her birthday's coming up, let me know. If somebody in your family has Huntington's or something, let me know. I would love to have a conversation about it, a chat. I kind of feel alone because I know people that have it, that have had it in their family, or they're familiar with it, or they remember. But I don't know somebody who's actively going through it, especially with a parent, not just like a grandma or an uncle. But I mean, it's all relevant and it's all meaningful. And I just, so that would be a nice Mother's Day present for me if I could be so selfish as to ask for something. So from you guys. But my next video will be a lot more fun, I promise. So I appreciate you hanging in there all 16 some minutes, and I invite you to comment down below, subscribe.